From JBS Studios in Greater New York, this is the JBS News Update with Teisha Bader.
I'm Teisha Bader with the JBS News Update for Tuesday, November the 2nd, 2021. Israeli Prime Minister Naftali Bennett continued to meet with world leaders on the sidelines of the UN Climate Conference in Glasgow, Scotland. Today's meetings included an historic one. Bennett tweeted, "Proud to make history and be the first Israeli Prime Minister to meet with the Crown Prince of Bahrain, Prime Minister Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa." And according to the Times of Israel, citing Army Radio, Bennett also met while at the conference with U.S. National Security Advisor Jake Sullivan last night, reportedly discussing issues including the U.S. objection to Israel's planned construction in the West Bank. Bennett today also accompanied Israel's energy minister, Karin El-Harar, into the climate conference after El-Harar was denied entry yesterday. El-Harar, who has muscular dystrophy, is in a wheelchair, and when she arrived at the conference yesterday, there was no access for her to enter, and organizers refused to accommodate her. After hearing of the incident, Bennett told El-Harar this was unacceptable and today brought her in his convoy with the accessibility issue resolved. And at the start of Bennett's meeting today with Boris Johnson, which El-Harar was invited to join, Johnson, who is hosting the climate conference, deeply apologized to the energy minister for what happened. El-Harar later today joined Bennett in a sit-down with Microsoft co-founder Bill Gates. Bennett later tweeted that at the meeting, we decided, he said, to establish a joint work group between Israel and the Gates Foundation so that we can harness the power of Israeli high tech in the global fight on climate change. Gates had spoken at the sit-down of how Israel, with its leading innovators, could work with the foundation, with El-Harar welcoming the partnership.
So I'd, you know, love to take that R&D innovation push and figure out where Israel can partner with.
As we see ourselves, Israel can be a very strong power in the climate change fight. And I think a joint venture would be really great news.
We reported to you yesterday about the break-in and vandalism at a fraternity house at George Washington University, where a Torah scroll was desecrated. Well, yesterday evening, hundreds of Jewish and non-Jewish students gathered in solidarity at GW against anti-Semitism on campus. There was singing, praying, and a Torah reading, as well as a mezuzah-placing ceremony at the school's Jewish fraternity and sorority. The American Jewish Committee shared a photo from the rally tweeting, "We are stronger when we stand together against Jew hatred and all forms of bigotry." Pioneering Jewish psychotherapist Dr. Aaron T. Beck has died. Beck is considered the father of cognitive therapy, noted for his groundbreaking work in the diagnosis and treatment of depression. He died yesterday at the age of 100. Well, the city of Jerusalem has a new service center for Olim, new immigrants to Israel. The Jerusalem municipality inaugurated the new support center today, which will provide services like help with employment, navigating Israel's health insurance system, and general counseling, offered in Hebrew, Russian, French, Spanish, and English. Mayor Moshe Leon said the center will help Olim in the early stages of their absorption and provide them with an initial personal experience in their mother tongue and in a familiar culture in order to make what is strange and alien seem accessible and pleasant. Taking a look now at our programming for tonight on JBS for Tuesday, November the 2nd at 7 o'clock, we hear from author Daphne Merkin reading excerpts from her romantic novel 22 Minutes of Unconditional Love and discussing themes of the book. At 7:30, it's part two of a panel discussion on the Biden-Bennett era with Michael Doran, Jonathan Schanzer, Tamy Ben-Haim, and Ben Samuels. At 8:30, Prime Minister Bennett addresses the UN General Assembly. At 9, Mark Golub speaks with former Israeli ambassador to the U.S., Michael Oren, on L'Chaim. At 10:30, an encore presentation of FIDF Live's Officers Town Hall. And coming up next, it's the ILTV's Insider. And that's the JBS News Update for Tuesday, November the 2nd, 2021. I'm Teisha Bader. Stay healthy, stay well.